This is the photo that I want to use to replace the existing image on the smartphone. I have an iPhone 6, so my photo needs to have a 16:9 ratio. I also need to keep in mind that this image is blurred on top and bottom, and the only part which is in focus is in this area. But I will show you how to solve this, so watch this video until the end. Let's bring in the image with the waves and convert it to a smart object, because this way, if we are scaling the photo, the resolution will not be affected. After this step, I can close the image with the wave and lower the opacity of the wave layer to be able to see what's in the background. Holding down Control, I can drag any of the control points to match the corners of the smartphone screen. As you can see, the perspective will also be adjusted accordingly. If you need to zoom in for fine movements, just press Control and Plus, and then move around by holding down the spacebar. Make sure the actual photo is entirely covering the original screen, so take your time with this step if you want a good result. When everything looks fine, go back with the opacity of the layer to 100%. If the image looks too sharp, I can select the wave layer, go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur, and apply a 0.5 value. By the end of the video, I'm going to show you what's the beauty of converting that wave layer to a smart object, but for the moment, I can see that the top right corner of the phone is reflecting some light, so I need to create a light reflection on the image as well. This is very simple and it looks great. I hold down Control and I click on the layer's thumbnail to create a selection around my image. Then I create a new layer with the selection still active and I create a mask on this layer. And you can see that the mask was created around my selection. This is great because if I apply any color or gradient on this layer, everything that I do will be limited to this layer mask. So basically, I can paint only on the smartphone screen if I want to. To create that smooth light reflection on the screen, I choose the gradient tool by pressing G, click here to change the colors. I choose the first gradient from the list, and for the black point, I bring the opacity to 0 just to make it transparent. The gradient starts now from transparent to white. Okay, I make sure that the new layer is selected, not the layer mask, and I drag a line to the upper right corner of the screen. Then I put this layer on screen blending mode, and I can lower the opacity of the layer to 70 or 80%. If you want to check a before and after, this is the result. Now, I need to solve this part where the phone is blurred, but the screen image is too sharp. I need to blend these two layers much better, but first let me show you why is it so cool to work with smart objects. You see, even if I transformed this image and changed its perspective, if I double click on the wave layer, it will open up separately in a new tab, so I can add filters, I can add texts, I can do whatever I want on this layer, and when I save it, the image from the smartphone will be updated. As an example, I will create a simple white rectangle here, lower its opacity, and then write blue on top as a text. I will also add a drop shadow to it, and I will hit Ctrl plus S to save the file. And if I go back to the main image, you can see that Photoshop has already updated the image on the smartphone. It's time to apply some blur on top and bottom, so I create a stamped visible layer. I select the very first layer from the top, and I hold down Ctrl, Shift, Alt, and E. This will put all your existing visible layers into one new layer at the top. Then I go to Filter, Blur Gallery, and I choose Tilt, Shift. I reposition the midpoint to maintain the text in focus, and I lower the blur value to something like 8 or 9 pixels. So now, if I check the image zoomed in, looks like the photo with the wave is blending in very nicely with the smartphone. Guys, if you have any questions about this tutorial, or you just want to give me some feedback, leave a comment below this video and I will answer as soon as possible.